here in the hub of the Mazza Vineyards Northeast Pennsylvania Winery with Mario Mazza. And he's busy in the laboratory because it's crush time. Mario, it's a family winery. How many family members do you have here at Mazza?
There's my father and my uncle are the ones that originally started the business, but today it's my father and I are here full time. My mother's also involved now. She's a retired teacher, and my sister's actually involved as well with various aspects of design and promotion and advertising.
Were they grape growers, or have they always been interested in wine making? How did they get interested in starting a winery?
My father and my uncle decided one of them wanted to start, when they were in college, that one of them felt they wanted to start an own business. My uncle thought it'd be a good idea to get into the wine business. They had grown up on a grape farm, but hadn't really come from necessarily a winemaking background, although they had come from grape growing.
You went to Adelaide to get your enology degree. What? That's one of the best schools in the world for enology, but it's in Australia. Now, what prompted you to go halfway, all the way around the world to wine school?
I was looking at a few options, and there are just kind of a pretty limited number of options in terms of really good schools to go for enology. And Davis was one, Adelaide was another, and then there's a couple in Europe. Being that it's French or German, I kind of ruled those out relatively quickly, but Australia kind of had an allure of something unique, a great opportunity to move somewhere that I might not ever get to again, and they had a very prestigious program that I actually had met up and already had a project in mind for my master's before I even had moved there, and had already been working with an advisor well in advance, so it just kind of all came together very luckily.
Now, at least in the wine textbooks, Australia is really known for its advanced practice, use of technology in the vineyards and in the winery. Did you bring back some of those ideas, viticultural concepts and winemaking concepts that are particular to Australian winemakers?
I've tried to. They're very much an innovative industry in terms of winemaking, because they've basically climbed the ladder in terms of their prestige in the world and quality of wines in a very short span of time, picking the right spots to grow the right grapes, which, Europeans have had hundreds of years to do it. They've done in decades rather than centuries. And so they've done that through very efficient use of technology, and I couldn't pinpoint any one thing that I'd say I've brought back, but there's a lot of little things that, we've kind of brought back over the years. Probably one that I could probably highlight that's really obvious is we started putting our wines under Stelvins over 8 years ago now, and we're probably in the first wave of wineries in the U.S., and met a lot of resistance initially when we did it.
That's screw caps for people who don't know what Stelvin
is. Right, the Stelvin screw cap. And when we started, none of the big wineries in the U.S. had done it yet. The Australians and New Zealanders were pushing hard with it and having great results. But in the U.S. wine market, it took a number of years till it was more widely accepted. Now it's quite widely accepted and well known. But we were really in that first wave in the U.S. to even bring that technology on board.
Did you have some family resistance to your new ideas when you got your degree and came back to change everything?
being a good Italian family, my father and I have had lively discussions about things. We've had different views on stuff, but it's been a great working relationship. He's kind of given me a lot of autonomy with the winemaking and great support. He realized that by sending me away to learn some things that, you're learning different things. If you're going to do it the way you always have, there is no point in going away. And so we've had a great understanding. It's been very beneficial to us building our business in the past number of years.
What's your dream for the lineup of wines? What do you have, like a particular grape or, when you think about the future and the quality of the wines and what they're going to taste like and what you're going to be offering, what does that look like? How does it differ from what you have now?
I think we're getting closer and closer to what kind of, a number of years ago when I came back initially, my goal was to, just become more efficient, improve the overall quality of our wines, work closer with our growers, and spend a lot more time in the vineyards. And I've kind of achieved a lot of those goals, or in process of achieving them. in terms of the specific wine lineup, you know, whites are definitely our strong suit. You know, we feel that we're doing fairly well with Riesling. We want to continue to focus on that. Pinot Gris has become one of Pinot Grigio has become one of our fortes that we've been able to excel in, I think, and we want to continue on that. But also, you know, ensuring that we have a good range of wines, because again, with a lot of consumers coming to the winery visiting, we want to make sure that everybody finds something for their palate. And we're not going to specialize in just one niche. We have multiple brands, so we want to branch out and be able to offer a wide range of wines to all of our consumers.